I have an enormous pleasure to invite to this tribune Professor Andreas Otto,
Heine
University of Düsseldorf. You're welcome.
Dark mode.
Writing equations, having dispersion relations of the key points.
Turning
positive intensities. This the Wood's anomaly. And now they can pick the dispersion of this, and they get this on the right side. And they will also work with this gold creating, and it shows a different dispersion in here. And they of course they have continuous light, and the light is reflected on the aluminum plate. So may I have the next slide, please? And if you now compare the Wood's anomalies with the left hand, where you have the high intensity or the black flux of wavelengths here, and here on the right side the flux of energy, then you see the similarity. Okay, if they plot this as now as a vector, K vector, versus the energy of the photons, then you see they you see this first time here by this the dispersion of the surface plasma polarities on the aluminum and also on gold. Then the next source of development is using characteristic energy losses, where you see plasmons, black plasmons, and surface plasmons. So let's start with this one. This is a development completely different from what I had before when we came from making. So this came out of work of the first one about electron microscopy, and this is the first electron microscope for which Ruska he made it in 1929, some years ago, he got the Nobel Prize. And he, and shortly after the war, a certain Mr. Otterman, measured the energy losses, and he found neutrinos of 50 dB energy losses, but he could not explain them. So then coming from Gelsen's measurements towards plasma of a solid state physicist, that's came really from Gelsen's plasma. Bohr finds they have plasma, gas plasma like you have in your radiation, but these days that's what the plasma was for them. And then they have third paper, they said they also now calculate the polar-mediated energy generated electron gas, and then they found the plasma oscillation of the system, the whole system, and the plasma frequency is written down here with this n density of the electrons in the metal, without that is the fundamental charge. So the Heinz or Pines in 1956, he called these collective energy losses in solids a plasma. So the plasma came from plasma physics. This is mixed. And then we have again a development in 1957 by Richard. He predicted a surface plasma loss at the lower plasma. And this is the normalized probability for the length, and it's not the energy scale. And as function of a normalized system. And he said, by electrostatic calculation, you have an electron beam going through, say, aluminum, you should have an electron energy loss formed as the Wood plasma. And that's what turns one. Co-workers paper in 1959. So because the vacuum wasn't all that great, it had an aluminum evaporator, and always convinced they had a clean aluminum film, and they had an electron energy analyzer. And you see here the big peaks, what you see, multiples of peaks, and there are big peaks which are due to the bioplasma. And you see this new peak predicted by particle on both sides of the theorem is omega plus and omega zero. And so what we measured, I thought we go down the light line, but you see this was just the red points are what we could do with the best resolution of the electron beam. We could not really confirm that this dispersion curve was followed the light line down to zero. So then comes the third expectation of surface plasmon polarity by attenuating to the reflection. So I had was working in Hamburg in synchrotron in the Lviv things. I had to return to Munich and the students led courses, and I was asking a student to explain this to me what the right side, why are these prisms reflecting through the wave? And then we came up that below the prism there is an evanescent wave. It was for the surface plasma polarity, and the evanescent wave has a velocity smaller than the velocity of light. And the SPP also has a slower velocity of light. And so if the velocities of the evanescent wave of the surface plasma polarity agree, I should have a resonance at a certain angle alpha resonance, and I should be able to excite the surface plasma polarity as a loss of reflected light. Now this was a very difficult situation in predicting this, and I had big difficulties to make such a small gap between the silver and crystal. And the next slide. So, how to control the gap? So, first of all, convince myself that the idea I wrote a computer program and I said, yes, there is a topic of sorts of cost value in conventional PSPT. At that time, there were only primitive methods for cleaning the photographic class plates, which choose very smooth ones. Then you had to avoid dust. There were no cleaning rooms at that time. I had to slowly evaporate silver films, avoiding little islands here and there. And I first watch I used a very simple method to control the homogeneous thickness of the air gap. And then the next picture you see the examples. And these are like this. Even this year, it's not shining like the first time. Next slide, please. So the experimental result from here, the surface plasma polarity comes to light. There are five different colors of the used, and the intensity here as color as light are given as a function of external energy. A better conversion in alpha. And in order to put out all the differences from the spectrometer lamps and so on, I took the ratio of the transverse, the length of the transverse, the magnetic field. And so here you see how this changes. From this one, I obtained this next slide. I obtained a dispersion of the surface plasma polarity. So you see there is this little difference between surface plasma polarity dispersion and the light line omega c. And this I published in 1968. Now, I realized immediately that there is a very high sensitivity. And further, so I have this as KSP minus area obviously. And the experiment, and then I use optical constant compared by flip curve 2, then I put in calculations 10x of silver sulfide, and then I put surface layer of 20x. And so I found it is very sensitive, but in 1968 then I found no application. Because surface science was just an infant thing. At that time, just the leaf screen was invented. We had the excellent leaf screen. And later on, we made a better picking of devices with interferometry, and glass plates, one and two, and prism, and buffers, and in this way, we could very well keep the two. And then I made a very good error because I believe so much in my computer program. And then I said, but of course, this is the original equation. This is not working. And I have what I have done wrong. I have the wrong side of the root of a complex number. Unfortunately, this place is global. This is a good question, but it's an easy experiment. Why didn't I do it myself? But I think I just was too much believing in my computer. And Professor Lviv knew my results and my errors since the beginning of 1968, which is the next slide. And Lviv was always interested in rough surfaces. And so he was always looking for the scattered intensity on the air side as a function of the angle of the air. And these networks are the surface plasmon characters. What they should have done is they should have varied the angle of the node to the other one at a certain angle of fixed. And if they had chosen this value of N1 minus zero at 1.84, then they would have seen a certain plasmon clarity. And so this is very often a finding that they can say they didn't find it. And so it was not able, but I was very sure. So in this 1968,
these specific antibodies. And
This is now a multi-million district. May I have the next slide? So you see that how to immobilize the lipid on the biogenic surface. So in now you have that method and you have many spots that you can do many experiments with this SPP resonance at the same time on the same sample. And so you have been several hundred spots per on such a sample. So this is 144 spots on the same biochip. And I thank you for your patience.
For a fantastic touch to our history. Professor Andreas Otto is a legend. He is not only a famous researcher but also a famous inventor. You may use Otto configuration to study surface plasmons. And Professor Otto, he received the Schottky Prize of General Physical Society for the method of attenuating photon reflectivity. Thank you very much. The session, plenary session is over, and I will pass the word to Olena.
Monuments.